Hi guys. First of all, I just want to say my husband spent an hour this morning. We've bought a new microphone and we just cannot seem to get it to work. So I'm just going to have to keep trying to remember to keep my head up and into the microphone whenever possible. I will keep trying. I think it may also be why my CC won't turn on the comments, the subtitles, because maybe it's not picking up my voice loud enough. But it's not that bad. I mean, a lot of people say it's fine. So, but for those harder hearing, I promise I am constantly trying to sort it out. Right, okay, today I'm going to go a step further. I put up a basic malachite sort of banded stone simple thing yesterday, and I said I was going to try the more complex one, so I'm back. Again, I've never done this before. I'm going to be attempting it for the first time here, because that's how I like to do it. It's how my brain works better. I'm not an organiser in that way. The only practice I have done is I did a little jelly roll like this, just to get an idea of how to and when to push the bits in to shape it. So, what you're going to need, you can use whatever greens you want. There's probably better greens out there than this, and as I said in my other one, I'm improvising with the colours I've got. Didn't work out too bad. So I've got sap green in FEMA Professional. I've got leaf green in FEMA Professional. I've got apple green in FEMA Soft. I've got jade green in FEMA Effect. I've got Cernit Emerald in number one opaque, and I've got some black clay, and I don't have much black clay, so I may have to be going into my scraps at some point. But anyway, that's irrelevant. Use whatever colours you want to use. I've heard a couple of colours mentioned. One that's mentioned a few times watching the different tutorials is wasabi. I don't even know what make it is, but I think that's used quite often. Anyway, I'm going to use what I've got. So I've got those. The only other thing I'm bringing in is I need to have a stack cane, because what I'm going to be doing is making lots of different things, then we'll put them together. So I'm bringing in the basic banded stone I did yesterday, so you'll need to do that and bring it forward for this. I cut one slice out to make some earrings, and I've still got the rest, so that's all I need. I'm just going to work out some semblance and how to articulate it, and I'll be back. Hi. So, excuse me, I've got a tickly cough at the moment. If I go into a coughing fit, which is likely to happen because it always happens at the most inconvenient times, I'll just pause. Okay, so we've got this from yesterday, so that's our first block, and we're aiming to build blocks, okay? So that's block one. Block two, I've got each of the colours I showed you, and I've used this cutter, so this is going to be my cutting guide throughout, so I know I'm using the same amount for each colour. So what I've done is I've cut two out. These are all cut out on a zero, so I've cut two of each out on a zero, and I'm literally just rolling it, and I just want to have them all the same. And I'm just going to do a very basic skinner blend. I'm not bothered about anything here other than matching them colour wise. So try and make sure you get the air out and work outwards. Right, let's see where these are at. So I'm going to try and get them all round about the same length. We know there's the same amount of clay in each one now, which is good. And then it's around about the same, isn't it? Yep, and that one just needs a little bit more stretching. There we go. So we've got, where's my knife gone? So we've got six there. Okay, and that's the order I'm doing them in. So I'm just going to give them a little roll to get them to gel with each other. I'll just turn it over. I think because I'm left-handed, I put more pressure one side than the other. You might find as right-handed people you do the same, so come on, off you get. You're not invited. And another one down there. Okay, I'm going to try at this point to keep them as even as I can. It will distort a bit, but Don't know if anyone else's machine is like mine, but it's just not balanced since I cleaned it out. And it always warps everything. Okay, I'm going to give it another roll. And push it together. Bring those down a bit. Try and keep that even. And then I'm going to fold it over so the colours are meeting the same colours. Oh, I've got a bit of something here I don't really want. There. And that's just a hole. Okay, I'm just going to push it together and roll it again. And I'm going to put it through on a number one. Sorry, I put it through on a zero. Okay, that's come apart a little bit there, but don't worry. Right, and then I'm going to put the same colours to meet end to end again. And then I'm putting it fold side first. I've conditioned this jade clay. It's a bit crumbly still, but hopefully it'll blend as we go. Right, I'm putting it through again on a zero, and I'm just going to keep doing this until I've got a nice Skinner blend, and then I'll be back. I'm going to take it down to a number two as well, so I'll see you when I've done it. Okay, I forgot to mention everything you need will be written below in the comments, above the comments, sorry. Okay, so I've done this probably about, I think I did it about 12 times, and I brought it together like this. So this is, oh no, sorry, this is still a zero. I haven't taken it down to the two. I'm just going to take it down to the two now. There we go. Still got stray bits falling off that jade, but I'm sure it'll be okay. I'm just going to give that another roll because I've done that. I mean, there are lots of specks, mismatched specks in malachite anyway, so. Okay. So now I've done that, I want to start lengthening it this way. So we've got a longer Skinner blend. So I'm going to do it bit by bit because I know the width I want for what I want to do. So I'm going to go down slowly and see what happens. Okay, I'm going to start off by, I'm going to fold it into a third because I don't want a narrow strip. So I'm going to fold it down into a third like that. Push these ends. Don't know whether I should have added anything to that jade because it doesn't seem to, I conditioned it for ages and it still seems to be very crumbly, but it's all I've got, so. We'll see what happens. Right, now I'm going to put this way on through and on number three. Okay, so that's a three and how it's gone. Might be enough, but I'm going to patch this end up because I do want it to sink quite tidily here. It does sort of matter. Let me do it like this. Where's a knife? I'll cut around this and remove the piece underneath and then it should be perfect. Okay, cut that piece out, put that piece in, and that'll be fine for what I want. Get it to mar up. Okay, I wonder whether to go down to a four or not. I'm going to leave it at a three and take the gamble. So what I want to do is I want to half this all the way up. It doesn't have to be perfect, but obviously as best as you can get. Okay, and then I'm going to half it that way. Okay, so on this one, I'm going to roll from light to dark. Let me just get rid of that end. Right, so this one, I'm going to roll from light to dark. I'm trying to be really careful not to get air bubbles in. This is going to get easier when I've got past the jade, I think. There we go. Right, so I'm rolling that up to there. And on this one, I'm rolling from the darkest to the lightest, so I'm going the opposite way. Okay, and then with this one, I'm going to roll from lightest to darkest here. It's just basically, I'm kind of doing a bullseye cane, or what do you call it, jelly roll, just to get some of the geode pieces going. Oh dear, now where did I start? I went from light to dark, so this one I'll go from dark to light. You'll see that the sort of geode funnels that grow up through the malachite are very varying in colours, so I wanted to get four different centres to make it more interesting. So by doing it like that, now we've got four different centres and four different outers. I'm going to add to them and I'm going to roll them out, but I just wanted to get them going. Right, now at this point it's going to mean rolling out some more clay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll each one out again. I'm going to do a 2, a 3 and a 4 of each one. I'll come back and show you so it's easy to understand. Hi guys, I'm back. So remember, I'm improvising as I go, so I might be chopping and changing a few things. I'll just see, you know, you'll see what works from what is successful here. Okay, so what I've done is I've gone to all six colours. These are all 2, that's rolled out on a 3, that's rolled out on a 4. 2 is the thickest setting I've rolled them on. I've done all of them in most of the colours, and I've overdone them in others. I've done a few extra, and it's just to save me having to keep turning off the camera to roll more and roll more. So I've done some extra. I was going to suggest doing 2 of each, 2 on a 2, 2 on a 3, and 2 on a 4. I might waste clay, but I don't want you to. So we'll see how much gets used up. Now the emerald opaque, which is semi-translucent, I've only rolled on a number 4. I don't want that coming through any thicker than that. Also, I'm gathering up my scraps because they're going to come in handy in a little bit as fillers. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do now is continue with these sort of geode cubes. That's all I know to call them. Okay, so I've got this to one side. It's going to have to go off screen. See if I can balance it there. And then I've got these geodes, haven't I? So the next thing I want to do is I want to start shaping each one. So I'm going to give it each one a little poke around. I'm using a barbecue stick, which is not too thick. Probably about 3 mil, just to push that in a bit. And then I'm using a metal ruler just to add the odd circle. I want to misshape it. I want it to have, there's that practice one, you know, that sort of misshapen look. Okay, so that's that one done. And I want to do that again further on, so they're different shapes as it gets bigger, and like say white with a geode, where they'd sort of follow suit, wouldn't they? With this, it's different. So I'm just gonna misshaped them all randomly. Now, I'm probably going to overdo it a little bit, because if you actually look on some of the geodes, there might only be one or two of these in the circle. But to try and make it prettier, I'm going to overdo it a little bit. Okay, that's that. Those two done. And this one the same. I'm going to do less on this one. I've just done three of them. And just the odd one of them on that one. And push it together and roll it. Fourth one, exactly the same. And then we're going to start using those slices to build on these. And even though I've run them out at 2, 3s, and 4s, that is just a guide for me. I may have to change it. I may have to run them through thicker or thinner. As I said, I've never done this completely before, other than that one little practice tube. So this is a first for me too. Okay, so it doesn't really, as long as I can see the centres, it doesn't really matter, but we need to keep mindful for. So I'm looking at that one, and I think I'd like to go a little bit lighter and then go dark. So I'm going to get a number 4 on the jade green and hope I can, it's not long enough. So I'm going to get 2 number 4s on the jade green and roll them through on the number 4 so it's longer. So now I've got a number 4 but longer. Okay, just want a straight edge for rolling. I know that's not quite as wide, is it? But these edges are knobbly, so we're going to be cutting them off. Actually, I'm going to bring it in a bit. It's going to help. I'll do it that way. Right, okay, so that goes on there. And I'll roll it round until it marks. I see it's ripped, but that won't be the end of the world. We can place that back. And then, there we go. We've added a green. So here I think I want to remove the little hair. So this is what I want you to do this yourself. Don't just follow mine. You know, use your own feelings of what you think would look nice. I'm again going to have to roll those together on a number 4 so it's longer. I've just put 2 pieces of a number 4 together, so I've got enough length here. I'll bring that in a bit. We're going to be rolling this out shortly, so let's see what this looks like. Okay, I'll just try and make sure I haven't got air bubbles. Just keep going from the centre right. Okay, so that's the colour at the moment, and I'm going to go back to black, and I think I'm just going to roll out 2 number 4s again at this point on a number 4 just to lengthen them so they're long enough to go round. And of course you don't cut against your finger like that, I'm not advising you to. Just my bad habit. Got an air bubble there. Okay, so that's that one for now. Do I want to add any more? Yeah, I do. So, I'm going to do 2 of the opaque emerald green. They're already on a number 4, so I'm just rolling it through again. I'm probably going to have to stretch it a little bit. Bring that in. Let's see how this goes. Oh, got a little bit of tint in there, but it won't matter at all. Which end, this end? It's hard to see what's already there, isn't it? I'll cut them in half at some point just to check them out. And I think I'm going to do a black on a number two. So I'm putting two twos together and rolling them through on a number two. So they're thicker, but hopefully, if it's not long enough, I'll have to roll some more, which I will. Okay, I'm going to have to just roll out a bit more. I'm going to be doing this throughout because, like I said, it's all working as we go as to what's right. Right, so there's a third one done on a number two. I'll add that to that. Roll it through again. There we go. That's going to be long enough now. And then I'm just going to place that there. Take it round, see where it marks. Then get them to meet. Right, I think that's enough on that one now. So that one's ended on a black and it began on a black. And what I am going to do is shape it again. So just randomly, I mean, I'm not making them as realistic as they would be. I'm overdoing it a little bit to make them a little bit prettier, but that's okay. I'm going to roll this one out a little bit and then cut the middle just to see how it's looking. There you go. So I'll try and match that back round about where I did. Okay, so there's one tube done. And then we're just going to do the same sort of thing with the other three. And I mean, whether you want to follow me and or just do your own random plan is totally up to you. So I'm going to roll two blacks out on a number, well, they're on a number four, so I'm just going to roll them together on a number four. So I'm just showing you how I do it and then you do your own version, but don't lack confidence to try, because trying is the only way we learn. And I mean, for every successful tutorial I put up, you want to see the rubbish that goes in the bin. You know, it's the only way to do it. And I started to like to step out of my comfort zone more and more now I've started doing it. It's black. And I'm going to put... What colours have we got left there? We've got orange in the middle. Yeah, I'm going to do on a number two. I'm going to roll two number twos together through a number two, if that makes sense. I'm just extending the length. There's still a number two. I'm just going to bring that in a bit and put that on there. Take it round, roll it to where it marks. Push it flat in my fingers. Then what have I got next? I think I'm going to go with a number three on this green. And I'm just being random, there's no rhyme or reason. What I would say when we do the tubes, I think it's a good idea to try to be mindful of having alternating colours. Just to make it prettier, because on the real malachites, you do get matching colours hitting each other, but obviously we want to try and get the best. Oh, that's going to need a bit more, isn't it? What did I roll that out on? That's a number two. I'm just going to get another one, they're all falling apart now. I'm just going to roll this through on a number two. I'm using three of them now. This is what I mean, there just is no rhyme or reason. Now I'm making a right mess. I'm going to try and reshape them. I need to try and get the same shape. That's not quite enough, so I'm going to half it that way. I'm just trying to widen it so it's the same right width. But it's cracking every time I try. Okay. So I've got that on number two there. I'm just going to add some to it because I'm not going to keep faffing around when I'm on camera. It's all right when you're off, but I don't want another massively long tutorial. So if I do that to there and put this through, it should do the job. Yeah. Absolutely fine. So I'll get rid of the excess. I don't want to waste that if I can help it. Right, hope that's enough. Then bring them together. Keep mindful of air bubbles. Stick that up there, a spare that I might re-roll through if I need to. I don't have any more of the emerald opaque left, so I don't want to use it too often. I'm going to leave that one there as well, because we're not making a gigantic one, and I've just got this feeling I'm going to end up making an overload. So I'm just pushing that in to distort it, pushing that in to give it a bit more of a pretty look. Okay, so it's just totally different colour. Let me see if I can get this one back off to show you. No, I can't. So, well, there's the other one I did. So they're all going to be different, you see, by doing this. So now I'm going to push that back together and then send it down there. And remember, we don't want everything being the same widths, thicknesses, lengths. You know, everything is going to be ever so randomly. It is what it is. So I'm going to roll black through on a number three. I put three of them together so I've got the length. Don't know what's going on here. I've conditioned everything. Right. Try and make this end always straight, because when you do roll, you've got a nice clean line then. It's a lot easier, and cut just inside the mark, because if you stretch it, it's hard to not overlap, whereas if you don't quite meet, the clay stretches a little bit. Okay, so that's that. I want to go straight back to a light colour again. So got these on a number three. I'm actually, because that's that width, I'm actually going to roll them this way. And this is the worst of the clays. This jade has really been playing me up. I don't know if that's going to be long. I know it's marked, but it won't matter because it's not going to show. And then if they don't butt quite up, you can just give it a little stretch so they do. And then I want to do some thin lines. I don't want it all thick. So as much as I've rolled these on a number two, they're now going through on a number four. Just hope that's long enough. I'll give it a little stretch just to help it. Just make sure I've got a straight edge for doing that. Then bring it round, mark it, and just inside that line, cut it. Then you can just stretch any bits. You don't want overlap because that's going to show on this sort of technique. Just put that spare up there. Put that spare up there. Right. I think I want some more. I don't want to overdo the black. I thought I didn't have enough on this one. And just in case, you can see that's it unbaked, that's it baked. So I think there was plenty of black. So it can be quite deceiving. I think I'm going to do some black on a number four just to roll around that. It's literally, it's like colouring in whatever you want to do next. And just keep referring to a malachite picture to give you an idea so you know you're not going in the wrong direction. That's all number four. Don't know why I always use this cutter. In my head, it's my lucky cutter, so I'm just gonna butt these together. I'm only doing it this way because they're already cut and then it's the right width. Push that in a tiny bit, straighten the end, then so put this round, take it round to mark it, then I cut this side of the line, so if anything it's a tiny bit too short, and then you can butt it up. Okay. And I'm just going to mark this one. Did I mark it in the smaller area? When it was smaller, I can't remember whether I did or not. Hope I did. And then I'll give it none there. I don't want... It's sort of like automatic to try and form a pattern, isn't it? It's hard to... I find it hard not to push it in somewhere just because I know it's flat. I get this overwhelming urge to overdo things, so I've got to try and be mindful now that I don't. Also, if I'm looking on this tray, I'm going to aim for the colours I haven't used much of as well. Maybe. Right, I'm going to use, while it's smaller, I'm going to use two opaques. That's long enough, it should be. Bring it together, then just butt it up. I'm also gonna do the jade. And then when these are done, there's only one more I want to do, which is I want to do just darker, just like a basic one, because around these tubes there's a lot of sort of flat banded layering, and some of it is dark areas and this is pretty light, so I just want to have one on hand. It won't be big. I mean, this is so trial and error. But yesterday's worked out so much nicer. I mean, even when I looked at that, I thought, oh, what a disaster. And then when it came out and the colours changed when it was cooking, I was over the moon with it. So it's given me the confidence to go ahead and try this. I'd have probably put it off otherwise. Hope I don't get egg on my face now. But if I do, it's all part of the learning, isn't it? I'm not worried to make mistakes. It's how we grow. And as long as we find a solution for any errors, it's all good, isn't it? Okay. Green. I'm going to add some more of this. I think this was the apple green. And I'm just going to do them on a three. Going to be long enough, is it? Yeah, that'll be okay. So I'll put that there, wind it round, mark it, cut just below the mark, and then butt it together. I'll try and make them different, but it's hard to look at those and, you know, it's easier when you're just looking, but when you're working with it and you've got all the colours around you, it's like my head's spinning now with what colour to do next. I'm going to add a black to that. I know I'm finishing on black, but no, I'm not going to finish on black. I'm going to add a black and then I'm going to finish on something else. I'm going to add a black in a three this time. And I'm just going to do it this way. I'm sure it'll work. Save a bit of time. Straight, straight, see the mark, cut just inside it. Okay, so that was a number three, and I am going to end on something light, and I think it's going to be this FEMA professional green. I can't remember the colour. I'm not going to name them each time I pick one up, so hopefully you'll start to recognise which colour's which. Well, you'll be using your own colours, chances are, anyway. Put that up. Plenty big enough for that one. And again, let me just give that a clean. Oh gosh, broke it now. It's covered in black clay. I don't really want to use a very big one, but then maybe that would be a good idea. So they need to be a little bit more misshapen, I think. They're really not. Even though they've got that geode essence, they're not balanced like a geode might be. So I'm going to actually misshape that one quite a bit. And again, with another thick one, just to see what happens. Then we'll have to have a peek, won't we? Okay, oh, that's great. I'm pleased with that. Okay, now that's those done. I still got some spare. So I just want to try and very, very quickly make a darker based, not as big as that, just a small one. But I want a darker based banded bit. So I'm going to go off camera to cut a few more pieces then do it, so you're not watching everything, you'll be bored stiff. Okay, I've got five blacks, or five nearly blacks, because it's done with scrap now. Different thicknesses, and I'm just randomly going to put them together. If you remember, with the banded stone, because I don't want it big, I cut them all in half. So with the thicker one here, I'm going to have a nice thick black there. I'm going to add some of these. So, I mean, put the odd light colour in because it does happen. It's not just going to be all dark, but I want it to be dark based, if that makes sense. So I can look at one and know it's not, and one is. Just refer to the malachite I put up and you'll see what I mean. Okay, I'm going to put two of these darker greens together. And then I'm going to do an opaque, the dark green, a thin black. I'm going to bring one of these apple greens down, but only the four, so I want it thin. Another thin black, another dark green, another opaque, I'm going to put a double black, hope I don't regret it, and then I'm going to put two lighter ones together with a thin black each side and add that. Hopefully this is going to be a much darker base than that one. Then I've got black, so I'll put an opaque this end and I'll bring in another one of these darker greens because this is probably the last thing we're going to be making towards it. I don't think we're going to need anything else. So that's that. Put it together just like I did with the banded one on the simple malachite. I'm just going to shape this a little bit so it's not flat. So I'm going to push in two there, turn it over, one in the middle, and we'll see what happens with that. Push it together so you get your shape. So that hopefully that will do and it will be enough. Now, this is where it gets complicated because I've fully worked out in my head what I'm going to do, and in my head it's simple and reality probably won't be. So I don't want these all the same thickness, so I'm going to shove this back down and squash it into itself. So I've got a, let me try and explain so you know where we're going. I'm aiming to have, look, a piece here where we're putting the stacks together no more than an inch high. I'm going to aim for everything to be an inch high. So that's the plan. So I'm squashing this down. This isn't an inch yet, so I'm mindful that if I can stretch it that way to be an inch, that's going to be perfect. I'm just going to roll it underneath as well. Yeah, that's more like it. So that's round about an inch. Yeah. So that's that done at that thickness. Then we've got this one here, haven't we? This is about an inch, but I want it longer, and I think, let me just look on the inside and see how it looks now at the moment. Yeah, I definitely want to roll this down a lot flatter. I've got this little fly flying around and I don't want to hurt it, and of course they're drawn towards the light, aren't they? And I don't want a splattered fly, he's only having a nose. Right, so that's quite flat, and what I'm going to do with this now is I'm going to double it up against itself, but I'm going to go back to back so it's like opposite itself. Saying that though, I shouldn't really, that's not going to happen. I'm going to do it that way so they're not opposite each other, and then that looks more normal. That's it. And then I'll squash that down, and now I need to make this about an inch, don't I? So just hope I haven't squashed it too. I don't want the line squashed so much that they just blur into each other. You know how it happens when it goes wrong and you've overdone it. So I'm trying to be mindful that Right, okay, that's that done. Then with this piece, I think I'm going to keep it, cut a piece off and save it anyway, because I think there's something else I'd like to make. And then the rest of it can go here. So with this one, I think I'm going to leave it. The only difference is I do need to make it an inch, so I'm going to have to squash it a little bit. Is actually it's time consuming, but it's actually quite fun to do, because there's a kind of a world your oyster thing about it, isn't there? Right, so there's, we've got three different slabs, three different widths. Actually saying that, that one's nearly as high as that one. I want to make this a bit taller. I'm just going to bring this one up a bit. It's better. Right, now back to these. Now I want these to vary. I don't want any of them being as thick as they are at the moment, so I'm going to give them all a roll. And then if I'm looking for about an inch, I'm going to have to cut off the end anyway. So there's that end. And then I'm going to cut off, I don't know whether to do one or two. I'm going to cut off two at about an inch. Okay, there's two. And then I want some much thinner ones as well. I do not want them all being the same size. You get little gathering, I don't know what to call them. They're like, they are like tubes that grow through. And they tend to have a lot more light in, and the surrounding malachite tends to be more darker based. So I've tried to keep that in mind, and that's why I wanted to have one darker slab. Okay, let me just cut the end off this one. Probably going to be about here. And then I'm going to cut an inch. I'm going to cut one, two, three, four of them. Round about an inch. I know they're all the same now, but we'll mix them up. So hopefully keep some spare, because no doubt we're going to need, you know, it's, suddenly you want to make the shape right and fit the right bits in the right places, and you don't want to have used everything up. So I just hope it looks quite realistic, but who knows. Okay, that's still a bit squashed there, that end. I'll take a bit more off. It's better. So now I'll take about an inch again, and I'm going to take three of those. One, two, three. So we've got three of those bigger ones. Then I want to roll some thin ones again. Do you know, I've got half a mind to put this up even if it's a disaster, just because this is what can go wrong. Stop being a pessimist. Okay. So how thin do I want them? I don't want them that thin. I've not seen really, really thin tubes, so I'll do four of them. Okay, still some spare. Same with this one. I think I might make this one, I'll do one a bit bigger. I'm not going to take it down too much, because they can't be uniform. But I am going to have to find the end. Go this side. Yeah, it's fine. So this one's going to be about an inch as well. one big one. Better end. One big one. I think I'll do a couple of mediums and then a couple of small. So I'm just trying to make it just over 2 inches so I can cut two ends off. One. The end off two. Okay, one to go. Also, they do butt up next to each other rather than overlap, but they do squash each other, so I might do a little bit of pushing ones into the other. And there was another idea I had, and I'm not sure what to use. You get this kind of arches of the colours, so you've got the band but it kind of arches. So I tried putting some of these together and slicing along, it didn't look good, so I've got another idea, but now I'm wondering if I've got enough clay there. I might try it with the spare. Okay, let's just take the end off this. Oh, that's the one I messed up on purpose, isn't it? Which again is what I'm just saying, you know, they want two of those. I'm going to cut one, two, three, see how that looks. And then I just leave that to for the really narrow. Actually, I might make one or two of them really narrow just to make a difference. Okay, so this is where we're at so far. Now, okay, so let's say I'm getting this one first, but I am gonna push it in and misshape it a bit just so I can push another one into it, like that black one there. So it's sort of going around it rather than all nicely butted up together, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to do a little group of these. Try and make sure I'm putting the different ones together. I want a lighter one there now. And then a little one of those there. I'll do a few groups because I don't want to overdo them, and I've got to fit this in between, so I'm going to kind of play as I go. So I've got a big one of these, and I'm going to put one of those there, one of those there, and I'm going to put two of those there. That's all light, 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 dark, so I'll have another dark one in there. In you go. There's just another bit done. That's a light and a dark. I'm going to butt that one in again. But try and do a bit of a better job this time. Push it right in and bring it out. And then push it against. I don't want air, but I don't want it perfect. There we go. Black green. I'll do one of these. One of those there. One there and then that one there. Okay, so that's three, and then I'll just do one more. I'm actually going to put one, two, three there the same, because I've seen that where they sort of repeat. Put that little man there. You're both black, so don't really want black on black, so I'm just going to cut a few more bits there, around about an inch. So if I put a green there, then a black, then that green there. That's a bit too uniform now, isn't it? So now I've done that, I'm going to take out one of these and replace it with that. Okay, and then you're all deformed now, aren't you? I'll put you next to some black there. Now, this is a bit, I'm really going to be on working on my feet. I'm wondering whether I can stretch this one out a little bit more so I can take a piece off, because no, I'm not going to be able to. Okay, I'm going to pause for 5 minutes while I have a think, because I don't want you to have to sit there while I'm just thinking. Okay, so what I've done, I've literally got the last few pieces, it's what, 8 pieces, and just randomly mix them, different thicknesses, different colours. What I want to do is try and make that an inch, is try and see if I can create that sort of banded arch I was talking about. In my head it's going to work, but as you know, I lie in bed at night and I create these amazing pieces, and then reality hits me that it isn't going to work at all. Somebody needs to clean her ends. I can't find a clean one. You've got string there. Right, so I'm looking at that and I want to look to see if I can arch it. So I'm going to push in three times at the blunt side of my knife. I'm going to do three. So there's three ridges, yeah. And as I go, I'll watch to see how that can go down a bit more. And I'm turning it as well. I'm pushing it in and turning it to create more of an arch. I don't know if this is going to work or be any good, but. And then on these ones, where the arch is, just right in the middle of each one, I'm going to push in and see if I can form some sort of an arch shape. So it's like that. And then push it together. I don't know what it will be like, but hopefully it'll add to it. I don't want it any higher than an inch-ish. Okay, let's have a look in the middle and see what I've done. Not how I'd like it, but it'll work. Okay, so now we're going to start looking at these and at putting all this together. So with this darker one, I'm literally going to half it again. After stacking it, I don't want it too thick, and I'm just going to run that through there, and bring it round there. If that makes sense. So I've got the lines. We need to sort of be mindful to not let a lot of air bubbles in. They are not our friend here. So I'm looking through it all the time to see for the gaps. Okay, so that's 1, 2. No, I think these are going to be still too wide. I'm going to stretch this out because I think if they're too wide, they're going to look a bit funny. It isn't until I get to this point that I can really see that. Is that enough now? Yeah. Just going to cut it. Oh, I can do that afterwards. I tidy it up. So let's say I'm going to go like that and bend that round, and you're going to just go in there, or am I going to do something? I'm going to use this. And I'm going to have to turn you like that to the nice bits upwards. What seems like the nice bit. Sorry, I'm mumbling again, aren't I? I'm going to bring that down to a flat. In a very, very lazy way. I'm just bringing it to a point so it ends. We don't want a sudden. I'm going to do that this end too, to add it in actually. So I'm adding that in there. Bring that round. I don't know if that'll be, but hey, we can only try. Then I'm going to add, which end do I want? I want this end, that end there, in there. And I'll just bring that round like that for ease. Although saying that, that looks very flat. I'm going to shape it around. I don't want straight lines. Right. And then here, got light there, so I'm going to put dark there. This is still much bigger than I'd planned. I'm going to squash that end so it looks like it's sort of growing out of somewhere. And put it in, squash that end so it blends in. I'm very nearly out of everything, so I need to make sure I've got these little bits I can use as well. So with this one here, I'm definitely going to be rolling that longer. I'm actually going to cut a little bit off so it's nice and clean. I'll put it there. Better. No, that looks like it's distorting a little bit. I might have overdone it. So we're going to find out soon enough, aren't we? I'm going to squash both ends so it blends in wherever it ends up. It could be that I've gone too far. I'm going to add you there randomly, slice you off. I'm going to add this one there randomly. Just want to we sort of closing off. I'm wondering whether to put a spiral of colours around the edge, because I know you do see that, but nothing that's made is going to be that big if it's jewellery, so I don't really see the problem there. So I don't think I'll bother. Have I got anything else I can use, or am I just down to the last of scraps now? Yeah, it's, I'm going to have to add that there. Now, it's going to be okay, or it's going to be a massive, massive fail. I'm going to start really trying to make sure I bring it in. And like I said, don't worry if it misshapes, because none of the geodes are organically perfect. They're all perfectly imperfect. No, what I should really do is just slice down the middle and see what it actually does look like, shouldn't I? Why not? It's all pretty solid clay, so it's not like... But it's going to take a little bit of sawing. I don't know if I can risk... Yeah, it's right. Oh, yeah, your name. I'm looking first for you, can. I'm quite pleased with that. Yeah. And there you go. So now I've got to work out what I'm going to make, so I'll be back in a second. I am back. I'm just going to make a simple necklace, and I'm going to use the same theme as I used yesterday for the earring. So I'm going to repeat that, but with a necklace to match, which I thought would be nice. So all I've done is grabbed a load of this clay and rolled it together to make a scrap back. That way I can use up some scrap and save this so I don't use too much at once. And now I'm going to slice it along the edge, and then I'm going to put it through the machine. Oh, I haven't quite got a whole one there. I wonder if I can cut that off and match it. Sure I can. So I just need to... No, it is that way, and it's just about there. So that is going to be more than enough. So I'll roll that through on a 2. Actually, I'll roll it through on a 0 first and see how it looks. Is that clean enough? Yeah. Hmm. Get some clean paper to burnish it. Actually, I did that on a number 0, didn't I? It's going to be too thick. Oh dear, I have to run this through the machine now. But that's not a bad thing, because I think I need to balance out. It's all sort of stretched that way. So if I roll it through on a number 2, it's going to balance it a bit. I've rubbed the whole thing out on a number 2. Yeah, I think that's probably actually better. But I'm going to need to use a little bit more scrap on the back. I don't need scrap on this one now, actually, because it's going to be done similar to the earrings, and it's going to be resined, and it's going to have another back behind it, so I haven't got to worry about that. I'm going to cut out a couple of these, and I'm actually going to cut them out on the tile I'm using, so they don't distort, just to make it easier. So I'm going to pick up some nice areas, and then I'll do a few, and then whichever one looks nicest. So I might make a couple anyway. Whichever one looks nicest I shall use. So, tell you, I'm drawn to that area and it's not bright, is it? I go, I'm going to do one there, and I haven't used the cling film. I don't think I'm, do I need to? It would probably be wise to use the cling film, wouldn't it, because then it gives it that rounded edge which looks a little bit more sophisticated. So I'm going to redo that with cling film. I'm just going to do one there. And I'm going to do another one. Where do I want it? Gotta do it there. So that's 3 of those done for now. That is all I need to cut out for this. I'll do the rest off camera. Where are you going to go, mate? See, you get over there out the way. Okay, so I'm just going to give them a little burnish. Obviously you can make something much bigger. If you do something like a domed round pendant, you're going to see a lot more of it. I don't know, I might do one, a domed round pendant, just to show you at the end, but this is taking long enough, so I don't want to be doing that online. Now I just need to use the last of my... Actually, I'm going to use pearl black this time because I have got that. As much as I've run out of the normal black, nearly, I've got this. And as long as I cut it out on the tile, it should be fine. And again, I'm going to use the lace. Leached it. I'm wondering whether to. I'm going to leach it for 3 minutes. I'm going to roll it out on a number three and then I'm going to cut it out. So I'll be back in a minute. I've come back just to explain. I thought not everybody knows what leaching is. So I've put it on a piece of paper and put another piece of paper over. And I'm just going to leach it for about 3 minutes, which absorbs a little bit of the oils and stops it being so toffee-ish, because I really do want the backs to be tidy. So I'm just going to leave that for 3 minutes, then just carry on like normal, okay? Okay, so I've used two alternating size cutters. I've used a smaller one. God, be careful, woman. I've used the smaller ones to cut out the malachite pattern, and I've used the larger ones for the background. And I've literally rolled that on a number two in the end. Covered it in lace, rolled again, cut out. It's that simple. That can be done as well on the back to tidy up the back. Okay, so I'm just going to put these into the oven and then I'll see you on the other side. Fingers crossed it's not an absolute nightmare. And doesn't have, looking at that now, it just looks like my granddaughter has been playing with my clay. So I'm just hoping, but then so did the slice I did yesterday. That looks similar. So let's see how it comes out, but I thought if I do a little slab I can have a look. All right, and I'll see you on the other side. Hi guys. Okay, so hindsight being a wonderful thing, this is that slice I just took off so I could see what it was like when it was baked. The only bit I don't like and I'm not happy with is that yellow streak there. What I've realized from I can take from this is that I do want the apple in there. Had it in my first ones, but this orange apple, this sort of bright green apple, this one, I put it in much too thick there and it doesn't look right, but I can work around that anyway, that's not a problem. So that's basically how it came out. If you can see it, not bad for first time. And I did one of these as well. Would have been rude not to. Just wanted to see how it would come out. This is the one I was making that I showed you, and I just made this pendant like this. So it would go with the earrings if someone chose to do that. And then I just did a, because this is my cutter of the month, thanks Deb. I just did this as well. Okay, so that's two pieces off of it. Oh, I also did a domed thingy with a hidden bail on the back, a domed necklace, but I don't like it because I don't like all that yellow there, so I haven't even bothered to resin it or tidy it up. I've just left it. But these, I'm pleased with these, and I know what I've learnt from it for next time. Alright then, well, I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope it inspires you. Okay, thank you, bye.